work and with us for sports.
So Taylor, I know everyone's been waiting for, you know, fall Trojan sports to get in full swing, and it seems like the time has just been dragging by for everyone to start.
It really has. We finally got to see a soccer match last week, and now it's like we've just been waiting for more sports, but we're just a few days away from resuming play, and we're going to get right into that.
Following a 6-1 victory over the Wofford Terriers, the Trojans are just 2 days away from stepping back into the Trojan Soccer Complex and defending their home turf against the Southeastern Louisiana Lions. After dropping an exhibition match to Mercer 2 weeks ago, the Trojans officially kicked off their season with a stomping of Wofford. Troy continues its series of home stands when the Lions come to town this Friday, and then the soccer team will host the Trojan Classic on September 3rd. The Trojans and the Lions will do battle from the Trojan Soccer Complex this Friday at 4. The volleyball team is on the road to Auburn to compete in the War Eagle Invitational this Friday. The Trojans and the Auburn Tigers are set to take the court in what will be the first game of the War Eagle Invitational. The Trojans haven't had much luck in the past against the Tigers, but Coach Sonny Kirkpatrick says he really likes Troy's chances this season.
Auburn's going to be outstanding, so it'll be a really big test for us, the first match of the year. But the first match of the year, anything can happen. So that's part of the fun of it. They went to Italy this summer, so they've been playing a lot longer as a team than we have. But if we play the way that I hope we can, I really like our chances.
The Trojans and the Tigers will face off this Friday at 7 from Auburn. Less than 2 weeks away from the start of the football season and the drive for five, there are two starting seniors that hope they can bring home one more Sun Belt title to Troy.
Much of the talk surrounding the Trojan football team is the amount of starting seniors that have moved on and what new players are going to step up to fill these spots. However, the Trojans were not left without any veteran leadership. Offensive senior powerhouses Jarrell Jernigan and DeJuan Harris are back to put their final stamp on their collegiate careers.
It's going to be a good one. You know, I feel like that's going to be a special year this year. We got a lot of talent to go around. And, you know, we're kind of deep in about every position, so we shouldn't really miss a beat no matter who's in.
I play a couple of different positions, a little quarterback, a little running back, a little receiver, then plus a special teams stuff. So we just try to mix it up a little bit, keep defense on their heels, keep them confused a little bit.
The Trojans have never lost the Sun Belt Conference Championship since Jernigan and Harris have been a part of the team, and they hope they can bring home one more conference title and prove the critics wrong that voted Troy to finish second in the Sun Belt this season.
Our number one goal is to win the conference first, I know they got us picked second behind Middle 10, which is fine with me. I mean, preseason rankings don't mean that. The postseason rankings that mean everything. Our little slogan, we got the drive for five. So hopefully we can complete that field to cause tournament championship.
I kind of like it. I like people to think that. But I'm pretty sure everybody else, like, people know. You know, we like us leading the conference every year. But it'll show. It'll show, you know. It'll all speak for itself later.
Just like the Trojan fans, the players have been eagerly anticipating the September 4th opening game versus Bowling Green.
I think we got a little payback to get from last year. We kind of went up there and they kind of, I wouldn't say snuck up on us, because they got a good team up there and we just wasn't prepared. But I think this year, since what happened last year, we'll be prepared and we'll hope to come out with a win.
DeJuan, Jarrell, and the Trojans will host the Bowling Green Falcons on September 4th from Veterans Memorial Stadium.
So Megan and Rachel, it's finally here. We're about to resume play again, soccer and volleyball, in just 2 days, and football is right around the corner.
That's right. Definitely looking forward to all of those, and football especially. I know my whole family will be in town for the game. So
I hope it's a good one. Hope we get revenge on Bowling Green.
You're exactly right. Me too. Thank you, Taylor.